What is going on, YouTube? It's Tyler from Mission VR, where it's my mission to bring you guys good quality VR content. In today's video, you guys are going to be getting a hot take of mine on how I feel about this new Apple VR headset and really some of these new VR headsets that have been announced, in particular like the Canon M Reels, this new Apple 8K VR headset. I think that these headsets are kind of stupid and they don't really help us much in the consumer video game side of VR. Yeah, I know the trickle-down effect is always there, but I'm going to explain why I feel that these headsets are kind of counterproductive and the people that are developing them and the people at these companies need to take a step back and realize what's going on. So before we get into that, guys, please do like this video and drop a comment on how you feel. If I've upset you in this video, I am sorry. I am a person and this is my opinion. As of course, I am entitled to that and sometimes that may not agree with everybody else, but please do drop a comment. I'm interested to see how you guys feel about this, and do subscribe if you like this type of content and all other VR related content. Also, I do want to mention our official sponsor, VRfinal.com, is a new site where you can go and get VR related news. It's a growing site, it's pretty cool. I would definitely check it out if you're looking for something news related for VR. Check out VRfinal.com. All right, guys, so I want to talk about this Apple's rumored VR headset, and this is coming from The Verge, and obviously we all know that this was reported by Bloomberg that Apple was hard at work on a VR-related headset. Now, obviously the rumors are flying about this headset, saying it could cost anywhere up to $3,000, it's featuring an 8K display, has a dozen cameras for superior tracking, and all this stuff. And that's all well and good, and like we've talked about, you know, so many times, the trickle-down effect is definitely something in the VR marketplace. You know, some of these high-end industrial applications that cost, you know, $3,000 to $5,000 to $6,000 for a headset have some absolutely incredible specs. No different than like what we talked about with the VR3, where basically the image looks almost real in virtual reality, which is pretty cool and, you know, will eventually make its way down to the consumer end of things. But here's where I think that this is stupid. And the Apple new VR headset, I just think they're missing a major opportunity. And we all know Apple makes pretty good technology. You know, most people have an iPhone, and you know, those that don't have an iPhone will admit that the Apple operating system is quite user-friendly and simple, and it's definitely a nice system. And on top of that, you know, their computer systems, they do what they do well. You're not necessarily the best thing for gaming, but they do things well. And overall, Apple has a pretty good brand of items. So I definitely wouldn't expect this to not be an amazing headset. I think it definitely will be an amazing headset. It's just the price of $3,000, it's not going to reach anybody. It's not going to get to anyone. And yes, okay, well, we'll talk about the trickle-down effect and, you know, the technology that's in the Apple headset will, you know, transition. And yeah, that's going to happen. But Apple's also kind of inclusive with their own technology. I mean, some of their stuff, you know, it never reaches outside of Apple. So if they're bringing out headsets for $3,000, it's just not going to reach anybody. And on top of that, I don't see this being a major industrial application, as it's there's so many other options that are a little bit higher end for industrial applications. So the idea that this headset is going to make any big splash in the industrial marketplace, I feel is kind of an overreach. And yes, absolutely, the idea of foveated rendering and 8K displays sounds amazing. But again, for the price tag of $3,000, no one's going to get their hands on this headset except for like super insanely rich people that just don't care about dropping $3,000. And when you're comparing it up to headsets like the Quest 2 that you can get for $299, it's a no-brainer that most people are going to hop on the Oculus Quest 2. And this is kind of a dangerous game we're playing right now, because Facebook is kind of becoming a monopoly in the VR marketplace and slowly but surely phasing out the competition. And that's not a good thing. You know, as much as the Oculus Quest 2 is a pretty good headset and, you know, Oculus itself is a pretty good platform, having no competition is just not a good thing. It's not a good thing for us as the consumer, and it's just not a good thing for game developers overall. Now, what is a good thing for the Quest 2 game developers is that, you know, yes, most game developers moving forward are going to have to account for the Quest 2 just because of the sheer player base, which is a good thing for game developers to be able to make money on their games, because a lot of times these high-end VR games, I wouldn't say necessarily lost money, but some of them definitely, you know, aren't as profitable as they'd like, just because of the small amount of users that are on Steam that are currently using PC VR headsets. But overall, I think that, you know, an Apple VR headset just doesn't do the developers any good. It doesn't do the consumers any good. And I think that they're missing a major opportunity to give Facebook some competition in this place. All these high-end developers want to come out with these headsets that cost so much money. I mean, look at the Canon M Reels, which is just ridiculous. If you've seen it, it's on screen right now. This headset is $38,000 for this little tiny thing. And I'm sure there's some incredible tech in there. But like this is a piece of equipment that's just not going to get used by anybody. And I think that there's a major play right now, especially for, you know, I'd say PC VR and just VR in general, for a high-end virtual reality headset that is affordable, that's not $1,000 or $900. And right now, I think a lot of people are missing out on that, which is kind of controversial when it comes to the PC VR side of things, because if you're thinking about the PC VR future, games like Half-Life Alyx and Medal of Honor and, you know, other AAA Asgard's Wrath, AAA games, you know, are we going to continue to see games like that being produced, or are the games moving forward going to be focused more so on being able to account for the Quest, which is not a problem, but until the Quest and the standalone VR hardware is good enough to run some of these major AAA games that can also be played on a PC, it just worries me that we're going to slowly stop getting full games and keep getting more arcadey, you know, 2-3-4 hour experiences. And I think that most of us have been here since the beginning playing virtual reality and watching as virtual reality is growing. You know, we want to continue to have those experiences like Half-Life Alyx, like, you know, some of these higher end games that have grown and become just such big playtime hour sinkers. You know, you could play these games for 100 hours, 200 hours, and you know, that's what people are craving more of, is the games that really just really light you up and just make you want to come back and keep playing. And I think that most of those games, at least for me, have been on PC VR, and a couple of them, you know, have Quest ports, being Onward, you know, and Population One, I felt were really strong games, and there's some other good, really good Quest games too. But some of these big story-driven experiences and games are only on a PC, and it worries me moving forward, is that going to change? And, you know, headsets like this Apple VR that are boasting a price tag of potentially $3,000, it's just not doing the VR space any good. And hopefully that we have at least a new VR headset that's going to hopefully come out this year with the Deca Gear 1, which is going to be a little bit more affordable, which will hopefully give Facebook some competition in this high-end VR user marketplace. But as of right now, it doesn't look like that's going to be coming out at least anytime in the next 6 months. And for right now, Oculus is going to continue to be a monopoly. And it's looking like that may be the future of VR in general, with standalone headsets, which I hope that they find a way to continue to make standalone, but also have it integrated in a PC, because I think the PC offers a lot of power and you can definitely do a lot of really unique things with a VR headset to allow it to be even more realistic on the PC. But let's talk a little bit more about this Apple headset and really what's going on with it. I'm going to read a little bit from this article here. You know, the alleged design also appears to borrow cues from a variety of other Apple devices, including the swappable Apple Watch. So they're probably going to have, you know, swappable headbands, swappable head, you know, head covers and different things like that. Oh, well, all well and good. Again, no one's going to buy this thing for $3,000. VR just, it's awesome and it's pretty cool, but unless you have, you know, pockets that are really, really deep, you're not going to be spending $3,000 on something you use recreationally. So that's kind of useless. They're going to have hand trackers, you know, be able to track your hands. Again, another thing that's not going to find its use in the consumer marketplace, just because no one's going to have this headset. So even with the trickle-down effect, I just don't understand why Apple is, you know, going this route and not making something that's at least under $1,000. I mean, I think there's no reason why they can't meet a $599 to $699 price tag, which would definitely allow it to be used by some people. And that's not even to mention, we're not even sure if this thing's going to be able to run, you know, VR games on Steam, or, you know, if they're going to have their own store. I'm sure they're going to have the App Store, but it's not like there's a ton of VR games on the App Store. So they're basically starting from the ground up and they're charging $3,000. Again, I don't think this is a very smart move by Apple, and it's allowing Facebook to get away with being a monopoly, which I'm sure they're all in on it anyways, so it doesn't matter. But Apple is reportedly experimenting with a variety of control methods, including hand tracking, eye tracking, a dial mounted on the side of the headset, and a thimble-like accessory, although nothing is said to be finalized just yet. The headset is described mostly as a VR device with more limited AR functions. So that's an interesting little line right there, because they're touting it to be a VR device and not an AR device, which again leads me to believe that this is not for the industrial marketplaces. Most of the industrial stuff that's been going on in the commercial marketplace is using more AR-centered devices for, you know, engineering purposes and whatever they're doing. Yeah, some VR is included, but if they're intending this to be a mostly VR-related device, no one's going to buy it. Not for $3,000, and you're going to continue to allow Facebook to be a monopoly, which is dumb. And that's why I do think that this headset is dumb, and I think that the Canon M-Reels is even dumber, because these technology companies are coming out with these headsets that are costing all this money and no one's going to buy them, which is inevitably going to be like, well, now since we made zero money on this, we're not going to go and put any more money into VR, which is, again, not good for VR users as a whole. We need more headsets, more people playing games, and more games to play. As I personally do believe that virtual reality is the future of video games, and I think that anybody who has stepped into a real VR game and not like just a little arcadey experience, a lot of times when your friends come over, you show them an arcadey experience, but after you've sunk several hours into a story-driven game, you will realize very quickly that this is unlike anything you've ever played before, and it's difficult sometimes to go back to 2D screen games. There's obviously some games that we all will still always play, but again, I didn't even buy Cyberpunk 2077 just because I don't really care for games like that anymore. I play almost exclusively VR games. So, you know, seeing stuff like $3,000 headsets coming out, I don't think it helps anybody, and it certainly doesn't help the, you know, the consumers. But maybe we will get some trickle-down VR technology that'll end up in the hands of some other, you know, major developers that will make it affordable for us. But hopefully we do get some more news coming soon on some virtual reality headsets that are, I would say, a little bit more accessible. Well, guys, that is it for this video. If you agree with me and you think this is stupid and no one's ever gonna buy it, then go ahead and please let me know in the comment section. If you do think that there's gonna be something good that comes out of this other than some trickle-down technology, I'd love to hear what your guys' opinion are, so please drop that in the comment section below, and I will see you guys in the next one.